Hey guys, how are you? I'm good. I'm doing this video because a few weeks ago I did this video on the Rose Solve and I was like, oh, this is such a great product. It's amazing. It's the best product ever. And I'm not rescinding that, but I'm saying it's not my favorite anymore. There's something else. This whole video is about products that I didn't think I'd like and I found out I'd loved. And it starts out with this one, which is Baby Lips. I didn't like it because I thought it was going to be like a teen type. Hold on one second. I'm trying to get my camera to stop shaking. Ugh. All right. There you go. Better. But anyway, I thought it was going to be like a teen type, you know, lip gloss, you know, one of those ones that don't really do anything, but like kind of got a shimmer to them. So they look really good on like young lips that are already like really smooth and soft all the time. And they don't really need a lot of work. And that's what I thought it was because I'd seen a video or a first impressions on the baby lips cheeks. Or the baby cheeks. You know, the same line as this, but for the cheeks. And I saw that and the impression wasn't very good. They said it, you know, it was a soft part. Like, it went on soft. Like, it felt good on the skin. But it, like, moved the product underneath it around. So it really, if you're going to use it, it had to be, like, by itself. And so I thought this was going to be the same as it. But my friend, because I have really chapped lips all the time. I've got really big wrinkles. And I kind of want to try it because it makes it a chore to put on lipstick of any kind. Because it looks really bad because it ends up, like, creasing in my lips because the lines are so deep. So, and like I said, my lips get really chapped really easily. And so I'm really picky about my lip gloss. And I need the best of the best. And so, you know, my friends, I have a lot of friends that are like, Smackers is great. And I'm like, Smackers does absolutely nothing for me. And I need a great lip gloss or a great chapstick. And she's like, try the Baby Lips. The Baby Lips is like, that's my favorite. I use it all the time. And so I was like, you know what? What the heck? I'm going to try to get that. And I also kind of wanted to get like a, I found some lip serums. I googled some lip serums. Didn't end up finding them at the Walgreens or the CVS I was at. I might go looking later. But I didn't find them at CVS. So I just got these. And I got two of them because they were $3.99. I was like, what a great deal. Now I'm still like refusing to believe anything can be done with them because they're $3.99. And boy was I wrong. You get a crap ton of product. This is not actually all the product because I have used a lot of it. Like, you can't, like, can you tell that it was all the way up to the top? It was right there when I got it. I've already used that much. And it's not because the product wears so quickly. It's because I've been putting on so much. It's such a smooth and creamy soft formula. And it doesn't feel like some of them where you feel like it's just going on top of the lip. It feels like your lip itself is getting soft. And it's really creamy. It doesn't have a color, but it's got a serious shine to it. Like, you can't really see it in the camera, but it almost looked like little bitty diamonds in it. And if you look at the actual, like, stick of lipstick, it's got sparkles in it. And then you can always get the glitzy ones that have more sparkles as well. But, and maybe it doesn't, and maybe it just looks like it to me because I'm crazy like that. And it's the way the sun hits it. But if it does, it doesn't feel like it. It's very soft and creamy to put on. I don't have any issues. And this is the SPF. They have an SPF of 20 for this one. And so, you know, prevents your lips from getting good. And this is a really good product, but you get the colored ones, and they're even soft, creamier, and look at all that product. Like, that's just a lot of product, if you ask me. But what do I know? I'm not a master guru. And this one's got, like, a nudish color. This one I really like, because I'm not, like, I'm very picky about my nudes. I'm not very good at finding them. But it looks good on my skin tone if I do my makeup. Like, if my face doesn't look splotchy, it looks really good on me. But I never do my makeup. But this one goes on creamy. It's softer. It feels like a lipstick, but it feels like a moisturizing, healthy lipstick. You know what I mean? It's not like this, like, drying lipstick. It feels like a lipstick that's moisturizing at the same time. It literally feels like heaven on my lips. I just love putting it on. I put this on. Like, I'll put it on when I still feel that, like, it's on. And I'll just, like, even though my lips are dry, or, you know, not dry at all, and they feel perfect, I'll keep putting it on because I just love the feeling of putting it on so much. I've had these for a few days, and I already feel like, I don't know if they're actually supposed to improve the health of your lips, but I feel like they have. And maybe it's the weather, maybe it's other factors, but I feel like these have helped me so much. And now, the other product that I got, I don't know if I did a video on the fact that I got these, but the other product that I got are Victoria's Secret Hairline Shampoo and Conditioner. And I originally got this because they were a sale for, like, buy two, get them for $10 each, and I was like, okay, why not? And I was like, you know what, I might as well try it. It's like, it sounds interesting. And the first couple times I used it, I was not disappointed, but I wasn't, like, crazy impressed. But it was because my hair kept getting greasy so fast, and at that point I hadn't realized it's probably because I was putting extra hair oil in my hair, which my hair really doesn't need. It was causing, like, the roots to get really greasy, and especially, and it was weird because it was in the cold weather, so, you know, you wouldn't think my hair would get greasier. Like, you think it'd be drier in the cold weather and not greasier. But it was great. Like, it just looked really greasy all the time. I'd be out of the shower for 20 minutes and I'd look so greasy. But so I got these and I just started using them again. And the last two times I've gone like 4 days without washing my hair because I'm trying to wash it less for the, you know, the health of my hair, because I'm, like I said, I'm not using the hair oils anymore. I stopped using them. I didn't like them. It's not that I didn't like them. I don't need them. If I take care of my hair properly and don't wash it every day, I don't need them. So I washed my hair the first time with it recently and I didn't know what was going on. Cause usually after a day, I'm like, oh God, I need to wash my hair. My hair looks disgusting. Let's braid it. Let's put it up. Let's do something. Let's hide the grease. I went like 4 or 5 days without washing my hair. And for some reason, like, even when I was washing it, it didn't look like overly disgustingly greasy. It was greasy. It was obviously greasy, but I mean, it was more because I can tell when my hair is greasy, and I knew how long it'd been since I washed my hair that I knew it was greasy. And it's the same thing. I've gone like another 3 days since the last shower I've had. And it doesn't feel like greasy. It doesn't feel disgusting to touch the root of my hair. Like, there's a shine, and there's a slight shine to my hair. And that's almost more because of the lighting in this room than anything. It's not like I go downstairs and I'm like, oh, you know, like, cringe fest. And that's amazing. Like, I have never had that effect with a hair product. And the only, like, I've done before where I don't, like, using oils and everything on my hair is a new thing. That's not, like, I've always done that. And, I mean, maybe I had, like, nicer hair in high school before I dyed it, but I haven't had hair that's this soft and this, you know, that isn't getting greasy every day in years if I've ever had it. And somehow using this from Victoria's Secret of all places, like, it's so weird to think. Because I'm like, it's a Victoria's Secret hair product. Like, you know, that's got to be one of those, like, novelty things. Like, they don't actually work, but it's because it's Victoria's Secret that you have to have it. It's like their running gear. I have a lot of friends that don't like their running gear. That they'll get it just to be cute because they don't like exercising in it. It's a novelty item. I didn't think it was going to work, but this is, I love it. I'm obsessed with it. And, like I said, I don't have to wash my hair as often, so it's, you know, it's a kind of expensive product. Like I said, it's $10 for 10.1 fluid ounces. But, like I said, I barely ever have to wash my hair, so this could last me twice as long as the normal stuff because I don't have to wash my hair. Like, I'm just, I'm so happy. And maybe it's because the season's changing and the weather's nicer and I'm taking cooler showers or whatever. But I'm just going to go with the fact that this is nice until the universe tells me it's not because of this. So I just wanted to check in and let you guys know because I'm so absolutely happy. No, with all of these products, I'm so happy with them. I love them so much. I love them so much. Okay. Well, I'm gonna go to bed now because I'm rambling and I probably should go to bed and my poor dog's like trying to go to sleep and I'm totally keeping it up. But good night, guys. Hold on 1 second. Had a burp. Good night, guys. If you like this video, obviously like it. Leave a comment with what your favorite products are and what your like holy grail wow I wasn't expecting this to work products were. Let me know if you like these products, like if you had the same exact reaction to the Victoria's Secret hair care products that I did. Let me know. And if you had the same reaction or if you didn't like them, if you had an issue with them, let me know. And if you like or dislike the baby lips, let me know. And this one, just to let you know the colors, guys, since I didn't say that, the colored one, the lip, like the actual lipstick, is 30 Peach Kiss. That is this one. And this one, I like the packaging. I really do. I like wearing it because I know that's weird. And this one, it's weird because it doesn't actually have a color. It's 10 Peppermint. And I think this is based on flavor more than color. They've got other ones, and they've got ones for, like, cold sores, too, which I'll have to try that if I get a cold. I didn't get one this year, or this season, which is really weird, because I always get cold sores, and I haven't gotten one this year. But if I do end up getting one, I'll buy the baby lips for cold sores and let you guys know how that is, because I'm actually kind of curious, because, like I said, I have really bad cold sores, and Abreva's really expensive. I mean, I don't know if anybody who has cold sores a lot knows that Abreva is like $15 for that little tube. And that tube's so easy to lose. Like, every time I get a cold sore, I have to get a new tube because I lose the old one every single time. And if I don't have to keep doing that, if I can spend $4 on this and do the same thing for me that Abreva does, then I'm going to spend the $4. You know what I mean? Especially if I can get one with color in it and then I can still look bombastic while having my cold sore and killing it at the same time. What? What? Yes. Okay. Going to bed now, guys. Good night. I love all of y'all. Like I said, like, subscribe, comment, share, do everything. I don't know. Follow my other accounts. They're linked down below. Snapchat, Twitter, Instagram, Tumblr. I don't know if I have my Tumblr listed down below. You don't need to go to my Tumblr. My Tumblr's kind of weird. And also very unused. But yeah, all my information's down below. If you have any questions or want to email me, my email's on there as well. Have a great day. Bye, guys. Or have a great night. Bye, guys. Love you all so much.